just one beat, communication. Wait, no, I think they said communication, but the Japanese accent was so thick, it sounded like they were speaking Japanese. And I'm not being racist, I'm just saying, I'm a New Yorker. I say water, it comes out like that. Anyway, this is the reissue of the Hiro Yui from Mobile Report, Mobile Suit Gundam. Is it really that? Is it really called Mobile Report? This is one of the many vinyl figures from Madhouse, from the Gundam Guys Generation line. They also have Gundam Girls Generation if you specifically want to have those hot little anime waifus. They're very anatomically correct. Ooh, Gordon. Without sounding too weird or lecherous, let's focus on the guys. Oh, I don't think I could do that either in the new YouTube. If you're an American, your first step into Gundam was most likely Gundam Wing on Toonami back before it started to suck with little cartoons that looked like jelly bean people. I remember the first day Gundam Wing came on, it blew my nuts clean off and slammed them up against the wall.
Mission accepted. Eliminate all obstacles.
Before K-pop bands came to America, we had Gundam Wing, and Hiro Yui was our jammin'. Point being, is this something you need? God, no. Probably not. You're only buying this if you're really, really, really into Gundam, or if you really just like Gundam Wing. Me, I've got a problem. I'm not on drugs, so now I'm doing plastic crack. It's not much of a difference. The figure's overall design is what it is. It's a glorified statue, or a glorified plastic statue. I mean, you can't do much with him other than take off his head to put on that lovely coat. The package featuring Relina Peacecraft. I don't know if Madhouse is going to reissue that. I certainly hope so. The only other option to get that now is if you buy a resin kit and then paint it yourself. I would hold out because these things do kind of retain value, actually. Weirdly enough. In fact, I see used versions go for way more money the second print stops on these suckers. So it's something to consider. But they'll always reprint them unless it's like a less popular character, you know, like Garen Zabi or something, or Dozel. Then it's kind of like, if you didn't get it in that first one, you probably never will. I have to say the rocks he's sitting on, well painted, I like the weathering. It's pretty standard fare if you're a painter, you know what I mean. You got your base coat, you got your dry brush, you got your oil wash, or whatever other wash they decided to use for this. And frankly, I guess I prefer this over the sort of generic circular plastic base that seems to be prominent in current Madhouse figures. Go figure. No pun intended. Other than that, there's not much else to say because the figure only comes in two flavors, with coat or without coat. That's it. Nothing moves, and it's literally not meant to move. This is for people who, like, collect Gundam-related stuff, put it in a glass case, and never touch it again. It's literally to complement something that you've collected from the series that you loved as a child, teenager, etc. There's not much more I can add to this. There's no meat on the bone. Overall, would I recommend it? Hell yeah. If you're into Gundam or Gundam Wing, and you want one of these, I believe Gundam Planet has some in stock. Yes, I'm pretty sure they do. I don't know why I pre-ordered, because frankly they didn't sell out, so whatever. Oh, he's not attached to the base either, so he's pretty easy to fall off. That's something to keep in mind, which I kind of like this approach. There's no peg to stuff in there, and then if you wiggle it wrong, it breaks. You just sit him on it and it's done. The funny thing is the base has total butt cheek spaces, so you can't get it wrong. You just fit Hiro Yui's ass directly into it. And if you're saying, Gundam, why the hell are you putting this on this channel? Because I asked Twitter if people wanted to see it, and a lot of people seem to be into it. So there you go. If you don't like it, find someone that uses Twitter and beat them up.